Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the third and final game of the three-game series between the USC Aiken Pacers and the North Georgia Nighthawks. Pacers looking to get the series sweep here, and North Georgia looking to come out of the road trip here with a win. On the mound for the Pacers today, we have Joe Marlowe. Marlowe comes in with a 4-0 record. He's also boasting a 3.54 ERA in his 9 appearances and 1 start.
His first pitch missing high and inside for ball one.
Second pitch will catch a bit of the plate there for strike one to even the count at 1-1.
And sadly, we didn't show the first pitch was done by Hunter Hubbard's younger brother. Hunter, one of the pitchers here for the Pacers. Mom won a drawing, and she deferred to her youngest, I think he's 11-year-old son. That pitch catching the inside corner for strike two, 1-2 is a count.
That one grounded foul and keep the count at 1-2. He was a little nervous, from what I heard, about going out there for the first pitch, but then he settled down, and he said when he goes out there, he didn't want any speeches, just wanted to go out there and throw the ball.
A man of few words, unlike his brother.
High fly ball there into center field, and coming on as it hooks into right is Luke Westerberg. That ball looked like it was going out to dead center field, and I must have better put a little spin on it there.
And you can expect here in game three, nothing different from game one and two. Both of them came down to the wire. Game one went into 10th inning before we were able to – Jonathan Banks was able to drive in the RBI to win it.
And tie it as well. He did so in the eighth. That pitch is in there for strike one to Connor Hoover, the second man. Devin Gearhart was the leadoff man as he popped out.
And not to be surprised or outdone, Max Schoen – came out with his high hitting ways and hit a double. I think we were down by three.
Down by two. The bases loaded, walked in a run on a hit by pitch.
That's right. So exciting games 1 and 2. So no reason to expect anything different here. Temperature's a little cooler.
Cool and wet.
And overcast.
And the count is 1-2 to Hoover.
I think we have a blistering 50-degree temperature out there right now, which is considerably lower than yesterday, by about 20, 25 degrees.
Yeah, yesterday there was AC in the press box. Today there is heat.
And it is beautiful. That ball fouled back. 1-2 is the count.
I got a moment here. Hoover comes into this game batting .341 with 1 home run and 6 RBIs. And we've got a call time here. And the 1-2 pitch. Going to be grounded slowly to Mercado at second. Throw to first for the second out. Pacers have Max Schoen, the hero of last night's game, behind the plate. Brian Pereira is over at first. Mercado at second. John Banks is over at third base with Tyler Ammerman at short. Chaz Powell in left field, Luke Westerberg out in right, and in center field we have Mitchell Price.
And up to plate, catcher for North Georgia, Sam Tiedebach.
Swing and a miss on the first pitch, 4-1.
See Coach Vanderslice, basketball coach, just finished his first season here with the Pacers.
0-1. A little high and inside there, evens kind of 1-1. The 0-1 pitch fouled off, right off the frame of the mesh there. Bounces right back into the field of play. So 0-2 is the count. Two tied it back. That's going to be outside trying to get him to chase, so count now 1-2. Tied it back batting .418 on the year. 6 home runs and a team leading 30 RBIs. He shares the lead in home runs and RBIs with Trevor Sams, who is on deck right now.
Yeah, Marlowe missed with that pitch. Evening out the count, 2-2.
falling that one off, and 2-2 count's going to stay right where it is.
Marlowe's obviously throwing hard, as he's apt to do, as these balls are fouled back into the right side of the netting that protects fans from getting hit.
Another foul ball there. So a good at-bat here by Tideback early in this game. And we're going to have another foul ball.
Marlowe moving the ball up and down in the strike zone, right around the edges. Doing a good job keeping Tideback at bay. Might want to bust him one inside right here. He's kept him kind of away from him.
2-2. And another foul ball.
And right now, he's just challenging him with his fastball.
He's figuring everything else isn't working. May as well just go at him with straight heat. Of course, when you're facing off against a catcher, I've always thought that catchers may have a better eye than most batters, but as that one is hit in the air to center field, and Price comes over and makes the catch for the third and final out as we go into the bottom of the first with still no score. And welcome back, folks. Bottom of the first inning, and Skyler Mercado will lead it off for the Pacers.
Daniel McCrary will bring his lefty pitching style to the mound for the Nighthawks out of Gainesville, Georgia.
That's going to be fouled off for strike one on Mercado. Mercado batting 302 on the year, has one home run and 13 RBIs. And here's the 0-1 pitch. That'll be grounded foul. Mm-hmm. And the 0-2 pitch. Another foul ball there. Keep the count at 0-2. In the field today for the Nighthawks, we have Sam Tida back behind the plate. Over at first base is Trevor Sams. Second baseman is Eric Delgado. That pitch gonna miss outside for ball one. Third baseman is Devin Gearhart with Connor Hoover at short. And in the outfield, we have Josh Proffitt in left, Ryan Tomita in right, and the center fielder is Steven Tomlinson. And the 1-2 pitch will be fouled back, and count's going to stay at 1-2. Just going to miss the corner of the plate there.
Just missed it. In the press box next to us, we heard a collective woo.
That was a very good pitch, very close pitch, but the count even at 2-2.
Could have gone either way, and you would not have gotten an argument.
Almost looked like he's going for the same spot as that's popped into the air into shallow right field, and that will be caught by Tomita for the first out.
And that's going to bring up Chaz Powell to the plate. Chaz Powell, who was involved in a pretty violent collision at second, and we thought he was called out, and it turned out he wasn't, and that proved to be the game changer of the game yesterday. Mm-hmm.
Kept the bases loaded, allowed a run to score, which put the Pacers within two, and then the three-run either single or double by Max Schoen put the game away in the bottom of the ninth. Check swing, but looking like he went around there for strike one. Chaz Powell comes into this game with a 318 batting average, 5 home runs and 20 RBIs. Nope, 23 RBIs.
Yeah, ball fouled back. Count is 0-2.
So two quick 0-2 counts on the first two Pacer batters.
On deck for the Pacers is Brian Pereira. About as baseball of a name as you can get.
And that one's going to be a base hit into right field, and that's probably going to be two as it goes into the corner. And Chaz Powell is going to trot into second base with a stand-up double.
Chaz Powell, ever the demonstrative player. Another one of those great characters. Talked about Cole Lee yesterday being a character on this team. The team's full of characters, but these are guys that are actually character plus. And when I mean that, I mean they are animated. They play with a lot of passion. And
it's always a good thing to have on the team. Helps lighten up the mood in the dugout, especially when you're down. One of those guys can really make the difference and allow you to come back.
Yeah, he's either going to pull you out of the funk or the team's going to kill him. It's usually how that works out, but those two guys do a great job keeping the team light.
And Pereira swings at the first pitch, grounds it to first, and that's going to be bobbled. The flip over to first is not going to be in time, and Chaz Powell's going to run home here and slide in safe.
And we got the baseball flying all around the infield as the throw gets away from the first baseman, and then he makes a throw to the catcher, and it gets away from the catcher back to the backstop. Powell scores, and Pereira ends up on second.
Excellent recap there. I wasn't sure how to. I feel bad for the official scorers as they're going to try to.
See, I get to keep it poetic. I don't have to worry about the numbers.
Yes.
And that's going to bring Zach Moon up to the plate for the Pacers.
I'm going to rule that an E3 because it should have gotten that for Pereira. But other than that, I'm just not going to bother.
Yeah, this is where you do as you need to do in your scorekeeping ways. Even our sports information director, Brent Hager, scratching his head, not sure what to do as Zach Moon digs in.
See a little smoke coming out of his ears trying to figure this one out.
That might involve some replay to get it all accurate.
First pitch to Moon is going to be fouled out of play for strike one.
Taking a shot at the visiting team's bus there with that foul ball.
We have Brian Pereira at second with Zach Moon at the plate.
And game two hero Max Schoen in the on-deck circle.
Pitch a little high. Moon able to check his swing to even the count at 1-1.
And the way he did that, it made my wrist hurt.
It looked a little awkward there.
One of the problems with aging.
Yeah, I still got a few years before I have to worry about those kinds of things.
It's coming.
Oh, I don't doubt it. That pitch outside for ball two. So 2-1 the count to Moon. Moon is batting .344 on the year. 7 home runs and 29 RBIs. .21 pitch. Another slow grounder to first. This one's going to be handled by Sams and stepping on the bag for the second out.
And not a bad situation. Max Schoen coming up to plate. Pereira advances to third.
And Max Schoen proving he can hit for contact and hit for average as he leads the Peach Belt Conference and is in the top 5 of the nation with a .538 batting average. It went down because he only batted .500 yesterday.
Embarrassing. I'll tell you what. This is the first time in this series that we've led.
This is true.
First.
This is very true.
Early on in the game, for that matter.
At any point, except
for... We waited to the last two or three innings, or extra innings.
Yeah, last inning or extra innings.
And that's when it matters most, though. You want it at the end.
So here's the first pitch to Schoen. That's going to miss for ball one. And the 1-0 pitch, line foul, and that nearly hit Pereira in the head. Had to duck out of the way of that one. So 1-1 in the count now to Schoen. Low for ball two in the count 2-1. .21 pitch. Schoen will foul that one off. And that'll even the count at 2-2. .22 pitch is inside and in the dirt. Good job by Tamita to keep that in front of him and keep Pereira on third. And the count will be full. .32 pitch. And a swing and miss by Pereira. The ball gets away from the catcher. And Pereira is going to dive in home safe. And Schoen will make it to first on the pass ball. So a strikeout. But advancing will keep the inning alive for the Pacers and increase the lead now 2-0.
That's going to bring Mitchell Price up to the plate. So Max Schoen getting it done one way or the other.
He can do it all kind of ways.
He's not going to help his batting average, but his on-base percentage is going to take a nice little bit of a boost, which he leads in that as well in the conference.
So Mitchell Price steps up to the plate, batting .316 on the year. His average has just been going up. I have not seen it, well, knocking on wood here, have not seen it go down in several games. He's had a very solid bat as he comes up with a runner on first and two outs. And there's a high fly ball there into shallow right field. And that will be caught by Tamita for the final out. But the Pacers get two as they take an early 2-0 lead here going into the top of the second inning. And welcome to the top of the second inning. Pacers leading 2-0. As we see Trevor Sams leading off for the Nighthawks. And that first pitch is going to be high and inside for ball one. High fly ball there into left field. Powell just kind of walking over towards it and makes the catch for the first out.
No need for urgency there. Kind of hit it almost right at him.
I'll bring up Stephen Tomlinson. Tomlinson batting .337 on the year. As 3 home runs and 19 RBIs. And the count is now 1-0 to Tomlinson. Swing and a miss there, evens the count at 1-1. Foul ball, now a count of 1-2. Falling that one off again. Going to keep us at a 1-2 count. It's going to be a slow grounder to short. Charging is Ammerman. The throwing is Ammerman. And catching is Pereira for the second out.
Ryan Tomita is going to dig in for the Nighthawks.
I just don't know what to say now. First pitch is going to be in there for strike one.
Evidence to the contrary.
Pitch outside, evens the count at 1-1. So 1-2 count on Tomita. And following that one off to keep the count of 1-2. Tomita batting .246 on the year. 3 home runs and 7 RBIs. Try and get him to chase one outside there. We'll even the count up at 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, 2-0 in the top of the second inning. And that one's going to be grounded into left field for a base hit. And a two-out single may just be the little push they need to start their normal two-out rally.
That's how they started game two, or game one. They were all about getting two outs before they started hitting. And
they did that
back to their. They did a little bit yesterday.
Yep.
Joshua Peterson is going to step in for the Nighthawks. Junior out of Arvada, Colorado.
Batting .231 on the year.
Max Schoen, the catcher, also out of Colorado. Maybe they're having a little Colorado moment there at the plate as they seem to be having a few pleasantries, I'm sure.
It's always nice just to talk with somebody from your home area.
And Marlow with a good throw to first. Almost had him. If that's him measuring up, that kid doesn't stand a chance.
Her pitch going to be high for ball one. Another check over on first. Or Tomita manages to dive back in time. Decent crowd out here today. Bunch of fans braving the cold.
And like the other two games, North Georgia fans here quick and early. Of course, most of them are probably staying in hotels and can't wait to get to the ballpark. Whereas Pacer fans slowly coming in. Sunday is a church day for a lot of folks, so they're coming in after church and looking really dressed up and nice. Probably nicer than they need to look for a baseball game, but I respect it.
1-1 pitch, going to be high for a 2-1 count.
Not a lot of wind out there today. Just enough to kind of get the stars and stripes to stand out, but not really anything that you would expect to affect the ball.
Unlike yesterday's game, probably won't see the ball carry too much with this cold, wet weather. As that pitch comes inside, we're putting the count at 3-1. Another check on first there. Tamita diving back safely.
Yeah, Tamita's not taking too big of a lead off the bag. I think Marlowe kind of opened his eyes with his first throw. His first throw was almost perfect.
3-1 pitch. That's going to be popped into foul territory. Showing going back for it. And he's just going to watch it go into the crowd. So the count now full to Peterson. He has a runner on first base with two down. And Marlowe deals. It's going to be popped up behind the plate again, but out of play.
And Tamita made a bolt towards second, but...
Oh, it's a 3-2 count with two
return,
down.
He'll return.
Once again, the 3-2 pitch. Tamita off and just going to watch that one go by for strike three as Peterson to end the inning. So we're going into the bottom of the second inning, 2-0, still the score. And welcome back, folks. We're in the bottom of the second inning. Pacers leading 2-0. As Jonathan Banks steps into the plate. And the 1-0 pitch to Banks. That's going to be outside for ball two.
Again, Jonathan Banks was the hero of game one. Two key singles. Twitterland had a field day with. Banks deposited two key hits. These are the tweets that you would have seen. The twits.
3-0 pitch. That's going to find a strike zone for a 3-1 count.
The tweets from twits like me.
I can honestly say I didn't put anything out there like that on Twitter, but that's because I don't have one.
That'll slow you down for sure.
And a 3-1.
Good looking pitch there. Catching the outside edge of the plate to even the count, or to field the count.
Almost. Think about it. It's almost an even count because you only need one more of each pitch.
Either or, yeah.
And Banks will follow that one off to keep the 3-2 count where it is. Banks is batting .386 on the air. No home runs, but 23 RBIs. And he's going to watch that pitch go by for ball four to lead off the second inning with a walk.
That's going to bring up Luke Westerberg to the plate with a runner on first here at the bottom of the second.
Westerberg is out in right field today. Usually the spot of either Zach Moon or Niall Goings. But today it's Westerberg. He's coming in batting .217 on the year. No home runs, but 8 RBIs. And he's going to pop the first one fouling out of play. And the 0-1. Going to be a bit inside there. And count even at 1-1. Throw over to first there to check on Banks. Banks not with too much of a lead, just trying to keep him close. Slowly but surely, more Pacer fans coming into the stadium. And the 1-1 pitch outside, making the count 2-1. I'm outside. Count out 3-1.
I'm not sure if anything happened on the video, but something blinked.
And that one followed off. Keep the count at 3-2.
We have every confidence that people will let us know if something goes awry with the technical aspects of this program.
And we'll have the tech folk come running in here in a bit of a panic, most likely.
Most hopefully, because I'm not going to be able to fix it.
3-2 pitch. And Westerberg will watch that one go by for a strikeout and the first out of the second inning. And Tyler Ammerman comes up, the number 9 hitter. Aaron batting .253 on the year. 2 home runs and 17 RBIs. And the only Pacer triple. First pitch inside for strike one.
I noticed that Chas Powell was giving Ammerman some tips, having already seen the pitcher and seeing what he's throwing. I imagine one of those tips is he likes to come inside on you.
Chas Powell, the guy to listen to as he hit a double back in the first.
He goes a little bit outside there, but low for ball one. Even the count, 1-1.
Another check on first there. And the 1-1 pitch. That's going to be a fly ball into deep left field. It's on the track, but it's going to be caught for the second out.
And I don't know if that was because of a tip that he might have got from Chaz Powell, but he didn't miss that but by a few feet, maybe about 6 feet from going over the fence.
Yeah, very well hit ball, but not enough, as there will now be two down and a runner on first for the top of the order in Skyler Mercado. Mercado 0-for-1 today, flying out in the first inning on his first at-bat. And the first pitch is going to be high to Mercado for ball one. No pitch. Catching the outside part of the plate there to even the count at 1-1. Pitch. That'll be low and count out 2-1.
Got a little bit of zip on his fastball.
I've been looking, and the couple of sliders that I've seen have looked very nice on this pitcher, too. So, here's the 2-1. That's going to be grounded up the middle and through for a base hit with two down. So, there'll be runners on first and second for Chaz Powell, who doubled in the first inning and scored a run.
Got runners first and second for Chaz Powell. Two outs here at the bottom of the second.
2-0 is the score in favor of the Pacers. First pitch to Powell is going to miss high for ball one.
Chaz Powell went opposite field his last at bat. Sure he wouldn't hate doing that again.
And the 1-0 pitch inside for ball two. Yeah, Powell sent one right into the corner there for an easy stand-up double. And then Pereira drove him home on that very difficult-to-score play, as that one misses low for ball three. Pitch right down the middle, and Powell just stood there like a statue.
He wasn't going to swing at that at all. He might not swing at this one, although his competitive nature would make it pretty tough for him.
And the 3-1 pitch, and he's going to swing at that one and send it into deep center field, and that's going to put him on a chase there, and that's going to be off the wall. And that's going to score at least one run. They're going to send the other runner.
They're going to stop him at third.
Stop him. All I saw was the coach's arm just doing the windmill, but held him up at the last moment, and it was a good call there. Pacers will get one, though, out of that. Another RBI double there for Chaz Powell.
So he'll just be stacking those doubles.
And that brings up Brian Pereira.
With runners on second and third.
Still two down. that leadoff walk to John Banks proving beneficial for the Pacers, as he was the one who came around to score. And here's the first pitch to Pereira. Outside for ball one. And the 1-0 pitch, fly ball into left field, and he could not read that one, as that's going to drop in for a hit, and that'll score one run. Forgot there were two on.
Yeah.
So a double there for Pereira will put the Pacers up now 5-0.
That's one of those moments where a righty gets that slicing action on a long driven ball and gets the outfielder. As soon as he turned the wrong way, you felt good about his chances of that ball hitting the ground. But it got him turned around some kind of fierce, as they like to say down here in the South.
So looking like also a few well-hit balls this inning for the Pacers. That one was well-hit. The one before that by Powell was just absolute rocket out to center field. And
you got some bullpen action over there for the Nighthawks already, and their coach is walking out. I think we're going to see a change here because they figured him out pretty quick.
And then,
obviously with two runs in the first, three in the second so far.
Evan, here comes the new pitcher up from the bullpen. So we're going to take a short break here and let them warm up, and we'll be right back. And we're back. Josh Bryan is the new pitcher for the Nighthawks as he comes in with two outs and a runner on second. And he'll be facing Zach Moon.
And this is going to put the Nighthawks in a – I mean, they're down 5-0 here at the bottom of the second. And after having two close call games in game one and game two, and both of which the Pacers came from behind to win with their last at-bats, you know, you got to know that the challenge for the coaching staff of the Nighthawks is keep their team in it. It's only 5-0. They were up by 5 yesterday, and they still ended up losing. You just got to remind them that the game's still going on. We still got a lot of innings to score. We'll get them when we can, and hopefully at the end of the game we'll have more runs than them. But right now you got to feel for these Nighthawk players. There's got to be a little feeling of defeatism going on. Mm. That ball misses outside, making the count 2-1.
I mean, you got a good 7 innings to play here. If you can hold the Pacers from scoring and a few of them score one run every inning, you just slowly that lead gets chipped away at, and suddenly it'll become a whole different ballgame. So here's the 2-1 pitch to Moon.
That one's in the dirt.
And the count now 3-1.
Good effort by Tiedebach to keep that one from advancing runner.
Yeah, he's had a very impressive.
He's very athletic there behind the plate, that's for sure.
And it shows he leads the team in average as well, so he's also got a productive bat. And 3-1 pitch. That'll be inside, and Moon will head on down to first on the 2-out walk.
And that's going to bring up Max Schoen with runners on first and second.
Schoen reached after striking out, which also allowed Pereira to score.
So he owes us a hit. Still.
Got to try to keep that average over 500. So 2 outs and 2 on for Schoen. The Pacers lead 5-0 here in the bottom of the second inning. And that's going to come in and hit Schoen. Could not get out of the way of that one.
The effort was there. He tried desperately, and that's going to bring Mitchell Price up to the plate with 2 outs and bases loaded.
Price 0 for 1 today.
Junior transfer out of USC Lancaster. Done a great job out in center field for the Pacers.
First pitch to Price. Going to ground that foul. And Hubbard having to chase after that one as it rolls back into the field of play.
Making his little brother proud after his brother threw a strike for the first pitch.
Oh, yeah, it was a good pitch. I was right down there at field level for that. And the 0-1 to Price. Siding in the dirt and tied it back, showing off again, keeping that in front of him.
I will say that Harrison Hubbard did not have the velocity that Hunter Hubbard tends to have, but it was the first pitch of the game, and typically you're not trying to show all your cards with the first pitch of the game.
He also was only 11 years old, but that's beside the point. 1-1 to Price. That's going to come up and inside there. 4-2. Here's the 2-1 pitch. That's going to be grounded right over to third, and he just stepped on the bag there for the final out. But the Pacers get 3 more as they lead 5-0 going into the top of the third inning. And welcome to the top of the third inning. Pacers lead at 5-0, as we're going to see Josh Proffitt come up to lead off the top of the third for the Nighthawks. And the first pitch to Proffitt is going to be outside for ball one. Change out balls here. And the 1-0 pitch, that's going to be high for ball two. It's interesting, just about being a cool day. Don't see a lot of long sleeves out there in the field. As that pitch finds the strike zone for strike one. Two-one pitch. He's in there to even the count at 2-2.
Well, they're in the heat of battle. They don't feel this cold until they hit the ball funny, and then they, you know, it's pretty ugly. That ball's fouled straight back. Keep the count 2-2.
And they get one on the inside part of the bat. Ow. And the 2-2 fouled off. And it'll be redone.
Home plate umpire going to chase that little ball as it careened off the backdrop and rolled all the way back onto the infield.
Two-two pitch. Swing and a miss there for the strikeout and the first out of the third inning.
And great job by Joe Marlowe's down in the hole. 2-0, and was able to battle that one back to a full count and eventually a K as Eric Delgado comes to the plate for the Nighthawks.
Delgado batting 193 on the year, has one home run and 9 RBIs as he takes the first pitch strike. Strike. Wow. What was that?
A whole lot of words in one breath.
Sounds about right. That one's going to be grounded to Banks at third. Makes a nice little jab at it. Throw to first. Drawn Pereira off the bag, but he's right there in front of Delgado to tag him for the second out.
And Banks struggled a little bit yesterday with his throw to first. And that one, again, he had plenty of time, and maybe it was too much time as he brought Pereira up the baseline, and he had to put a hard tag on the young man run into first.
So with two down, we'll see the top of the order with Devin Gearhart. And he'll take a first pitch, strike one.
Gearhart's been hitting pretty hard this week.
That he has. And he also made the final out of that bases-loaded jam in the second inning. And that one fouled off and out of play.
Fouled that one into the picnic area. Weather like this, there's not many people picnicking in the picnic area, so no damage done. But the count is 0-2.
Swing and a miss for strike three and the third out of the inning as they go down 1-2-3, keeping the Pacer 5-0 lead intact, going into the bottom of the third. And we are in the bottom of the third inning. Pacers leading 5-0 as John Banks leads off. Banks walked and scored a run in the second inning on his first plate appearance. And he's going to line one there into left field for a base hit and possibly more as it goes into the corner.
That was a weird swing. He went upstairs to hit that thing. I think he made contact with the ball above his head, but somehow got it, pulled it down to left field, and ended up on second.
So a leadoff double brings up Luke Westerberg. Struck out looking in his first at-bat. First pitch to Westerberg is outside for ball one. And the 1-0 pitch, missing high and inside for ball two. Allen grounded right back to the mound and mishandled, but he's able to underhand it over to Sams at first for the first out.
That was how you make an easy play look less easy.
It went into his glove, and it looked like as he was turning, it may have rolled out of the glove. Yeah. But luckily, it rolled towards first.
That could have been a nightmare had it rolled a little bit farther to his left towards second base, because that would have made for a pretty close play as Tyler Ammerman will step into the box with runner on second, one out, here at the bottom of the third.
First pitch just going to miss for ball one.
And there's already two pitchers throwing over in the bullpen for the Nighthawks.
Kind of wonder how many they're going to be willing to use. They used an awful lot of pitchers in just the bottom of the ninth alone last night.
They really did. They went through a lot of pitchers, and it may be one of those situations where you end up having to bring in a kid who hadn't pitched since high school just to be able to throw a ball across the plate.
Well, the count is 2-0 to Ammerman. Flew out on a well-hit ball back in the second inning. And the 2-0 pitch. That one finds the strike zone for a 2-1 count.
That one seemed a little high as there's a little bit of a grumble in the crowd. Our typical Boo Bird's not here today, so it's not as vocal. Collectively, though, there was a grumble there, and that did look a little high, but
that one certainly was high enough as the count now 3-1. Usually when you have to make the catcher stand up to catch it, it is going
to
be high.
Tends to be high unless he's a 3-foot-tall catcher.
That's true. Or the batter's 8 feet. Three-one pitch from Brian. It's going to be lined right to short. They're going to try for a double play here, and that's going to go over the head of Delgado.
And Delgado may make a run all the way to home as first baseman races to get the ball and cannot get it in time. And
Banks makes it all the way home on that attempted double play gone wrong.
He may need some oxygen after that one, but they keep their scoring streak alive if they score for the third straight inning. And that was an error, obviously.
And top of the order now comes up with two down with Skyler Mercado. Singled and scored a run in his 1-for-2 day so far. has batted now in every inning so far. That's an interesting little stat.
It's usually a good sign for your home team.
As that one's in the dirt for ball one. And the 1-0 pitch comes inside on Mercado, who turns away, and the count now 2-0. And the 1-0. That was going to be a bit high inside, and the count now 2-0. Pretty much down the middle there, and the count now 2-1. And grounded to third. Nice little grab there by Gearhart as he throws to first for the final out. Pacers get one, though, and increase their lead to 6-0 going into the top of the fourth by that score. And we are in the top of the fourth inning, and leading off for the Nighthawks is the shortstop, Connor Hoover, as they trail the USC Aiken Pacers 6-0, and Hoover will watch the first pitch go by for ball one. Pitch, a bit low there, and the count 2-0. That's a well-hit ball into right field, and that's going to be a base hit and more as that goes off the wall. Westerberg is going to bring it in there, and there's going to be a play at second. However, it's not in time. So a leadoff double for Connor Hoover. Close play, a little closer than I thought it was going to be, but Hoover able to beat it out and make it to second base to lead off the fourth.
Depending on what color you're wearing, he was safe or he was out.
Very close play.
Very close play and good effort by all involved.
Hitter, fielder, everybody. And now Sam Tiedebach comes up 0-1 today. Flew out in the first. He comes up with a runner on second and nobody out. That first pitch going to come inside on him for ball one. 1-0 pitch. A little high, and the count now 2-0. High fly ball into left center field. Coming on and making the catch is Powell for the first out. Had to wait a moment there because everybody was converging on one point. Wasn't sure who had called for it. I'll bring up Trevor Sams.
Chaz Powell proved to be the loudest of the between the shortstop, center fielder, and left field.
Sometimes it's not the fastest, it's the loudest that gets it. Like they say, the squeaky gear gets the oil, or grease, or whatever you want. I don't remember these sayings.
Good effort, though. We applaud. We applaud the effort. It's been a heck of a series. We're all a little brain-numbed.
So an 0-1 count to Trevor Sams, as he comes up with one on and one out. Swing and a miss there, and the count is now 0-2. And the 0-2. Swing and a miss for strike three and the second out.
Joe Marlowe has just been on cruise control. So far up to this point, he's been throwing with confidence, and he seems to be really relaxed out there. Of course, having an offensive outing like this, for, you know, we haven't seen this until late innings. This has given him a little bit of a reprieve.
I'm sure the other starters are like, hey, where was this when I was on the mound?
It could be a question.
So with two down and a swinging and missing is Stephen Tomlinson. That was just a straight heat right there. 0-1 the count to Tomlinson with a runner on second and two out. That one's going to be outside and low for ball one, evens the count up. One pitch.
Good piece of hitting there.
And Price is going to track it down near the track for the final out. We're going into the bottom of the fourth inning. Pacers still leading 6-0. And welcome to the bottom of the fourth inning. Pacers are leading 6-0 as Chaz Powell comes to the plate. Two doubles today, two runs scored and an RBI. So he's responsible in part for half of the Pacer runs.
Having a good day for Mr. Powell.
That first pitch is going to be outside for ball one.
Pitcher a little scared to throw at him.
Well, then you've gotten two doubles off of somebody. And the 1-0. That one finds the strike zone to even the count at 1-1.
And just to give you a picture of depth between these two programs, right now there is nobody even in the Pacer bullpen. You look over at the Nighthawks bullpen, they got a slew of guys, probably 7 or 8 guys out there. One's actually throwing. But, you know, as you said, they used up a lot of their pitchers late in the game last night trying to hold on to a victory. They wanted to win and had every chance to get it. But with that, with the exception of Matt Schoen's timely hit, but, you know, we've got Joe Marlowe on the mound, and Joe Marlowe could go 6-7 easy, if not full.
That one's going to hit, pal, and he'll head on down to first to lead off.
And I'm looking down at some North Georgia fans, and they're kind of questioning, why did he get to go when their batter didn't get to go yesterday? And
that was a bit of a controversial moment
Well, and again, their batter never moved, and you've got to make some effort to get out of the way of the ball. Chaz Powell definitely ducked. In fact, he's over there talking to the guy who got plunked yesterday. I think it was their first
pitch. Yeah, I believe it was. It was him, yes.
As Brian Pereira will dig in.
Pereira has an RBI double, and he's going to get a nice hit here into right center field.
That's going to put runners on the corner for the Pacers, as Powell will go all the way to third and had to pull out a parachute to stop.
He was going full speed there. Might have been thinking that the ball was going to go into the gap and into the wall, but
it was a good hustle on the Nighthawks outfield to get over there.
Tamita made it over there, showing some speed, and got it in fast. Holding Pereira to a single and only putting Powell on third. So runners on the corners for Zach Moon with actually nobody out. Moon 0-for-1 today with a walk. That pitch comes inside on the corner there, 4-1. Oh, one pitch. Good job there. Wow. By Tideback.
I don't know how, because Tideback had his wrist all turned funny to dig that, and
that was very impressive.
How that didn't bounce off his glove, that was
some skill right there.
That's definitely not something he was coached. That was an instinctive play on the ball, and somehow got it.
So 1-1 is the count to Moon. And they're going to call a balk here.
That's going to advance the runners, and we'll score one on this advance as Chaz Powell trots in from third. And Chaz looks like he's a little gimpy on his right foot. I noticed he came into third kind of funny as he was trying to stop, but Chaz Powell's that's not going to slow him down. He's going to be fine. And but that balk
continues.
Continues.
That's the word I'm looking for. It also does increase the pace of the lead, 7-0 now, but it continues the scoring throughout every inning. Here's a 1-1 to Moon. He's going to ground that to third. That's going to be grabbed there by Gearhart, and he's going to throw for first for the first out.
Great play by Gearhart, too. Gearhart's got a laser of a throw to first from third.
Got a good, yeah, very good arm there, and he's able to read the bounce really well. That was a very well-hit ball by Moon.
So here we go, Max Schoen. He's yet to get a hit, but he's been on base his first two times up.
So There'll be a runner on second for Schoen with one out. High fly ball there into right field. And Tomita comes on and makes the catch. And it's looking like Pereira wanted to tag from second. However, he's going to stay put right where he is.
And you could almost think almost anybody else on second may have been given a chance to go. But I think with Pereira, who's built for brute ability.
Or for power.
Not for speed. Mitchell Price, who is built for speed, will come up to plate for the Pacers. Pacers lead 7-0 here at the bottom of the fourth. Two outs, runner on second.
Price is 0-2 today. He's going to hit one into right field. And that one's going to go down the line there, and that is just going to hook foul. Problem when you hit one opposite field, it's got that little curve on it. So it'll be strike one to Mitchell Price. And the 0-1 to Price in the dirt, blocked by Tida back. Evens the count at 1-1. Almost called him Tomita, and I have no idea why.
Tida back?
Yeah, Tida back. I almost called him Tomita. I know they.
Yeah, that's not even a Tomita tomato conversation. That's a whole other world.
Oh, that's probably it. Tomita is number 24, while Tideback's number 42. I just flipped them around.
You just went dyslexic on it.
Just a little bit.
Gotcha.
1-1, grounded.
That's going to get through.
Score base hit.
That's going to score one as Pereira rounds third and will easily touch home. So Mitchell Price getting it done from the plate as
RBI
well
single.
As from the field. Now bring up Jonathan Banks.
Banks is 1-for-1 today. Doubled, scored two runs, and has a walk.
He's having a fine day at the plate. A lot of Pacers hitting ball well today. Of course, I mean, and this isn't not their pitching staff, but when you get into the third pitcher and on, and we got into their third pitcher pretty quick, third starter, I meant, for the series. We got into him pretty early, and that really throws your strategy all out of whack when you're the coach for the Nighthawks.
Pacers were just saving up their bats for today's game. They struggled early on in the series.
Hey, we got them when we needed them.
They got the timely hits, though. That's all that mattered.
Right. We got them when we needed them.
And the count is 0-1 to Banks. 8-0 is the score, with two outs, a runner on first, here in the bottom of the fourth inning.
I believe we play Payne College sometime this week, Tuesday or Wednesday.
Wednesday we play them at 6 o'clock. And the count even at 1-1. One to Banks. That'll be outside and low for ball two.
Pretty stoic crowd out there. North Georgia fans not enjoying the game up to this point. It's hard to question them for that. But there's still a lot of baseball left. We've seen this time and time again, as that ball's hit to short. Short will handle it. Quick throw to second to retire the side, but not before the Pacers put two more up. We lead 8-0 as we head to the top of the fifth. We'll be right back.
For Breakaway and Fats Cafe, this is a 30-second radio spot titled A Million Bucks Poppy Seed Rolls Dinner Deal.
Every time you come into Fats Cafe, you get a big basket of our famous warm poppy seed rolls. People ask us all the time, these taste like a million bucks. Why would you give them away for free? The simple answer is, it's a good question. What are we doing?
Don't worry, our poppy seed rolls will always be free. Compliment them with one of a dozen delicious dinner entrees for under $10, like our deep dish chicken pot pie. Fats Cafe, feed your soul.
For break.
And welcome to the top of the fifth inning, folks. Ryan Tomita will lead it off for the Nighthawks as they trail the USC Aiken Pacers 8-0. And the first pitch there is in there for strike one. Tomita, 1-for-1 today with a single. And he's going to hit a high fly ball there into right field. Westerberg tracking it down. And he will make the catch near the warning track for the first out. That'll bring up Josh Peterson, 0-for-1 today with a strikeout. He's going to hit one up the middle there for a base hit. I'll put one on with one out in the top of the fifth. And that'll bring up left fielder Josh Proffitt, who is also struck out today, is 0-for-1. And we're going to have a pinch hitter here. Connor Corbett comes in to bat for Josh Proffitt. First pitch to Corbett. Swing and a miss for strike one. Corbett batting 154 on the year. No home runs and four RBIs in his four games. That's a high fly ball into center field. And Price tracking it down, making the catch for the second out. That'll bring up Eric Delgado, 0-for-1 today. Delgado comes up with two down and a runner on first base. Trailing 8-0 here in the top of the fifth inning. And the first pitch from Marlowe is going to be a bit low for ball one. And a check throw over to first there. Trying to keep Peterson close. One-oh pitch. That'll be a bit high for ball two. 2-0 the count to Delgado. High fly ball there into foul territory along the third base line. And Ammerman comes on and makes the play all the way from short for the final out of the inning. So we're going into the bottom of the fifth. 8-0 is still the score. Well, in the bottom of the fifth inning, 8-0 is the score as Westerberg fouls off the first pitch and out of play. Westerberg 0-for-2 today with a strikeout and a ground out.
Zach Werner is on the mound for the Nighthawks. Werner out of Venetia, Pennsylvania. Got a 1-1 pitch.
Werner is has an ERA of 4.5 on the year in his three appearances. No record, though. Win-loss is at 0-0. And here's the 1-1.
And he's a junior, so he's not new to this. That ball's going to be fouled out of play. Made the count 1-2. That ball will end up on the back of the Gator. Convenient.
So 1-2 the count to Westerberg.
Got to give Coach Kenny Thomas credit for putting this team together again at the beginning of the season.
That one's going to be a base hit into left field.
And I don't, that's going to be one of those ones where he probably should have made a play on that ball, but Gearhart, it was on him quick.
Yeah, it was a one hopper, and that one hop came real close to him. Basically just sticking out his glove and hoping that he gets it, but also trying not to get killed.
Get beamed by it, yeah. And your instincts say duck or get out of the way. But your coaching tells you, nope, square up to it and make a play on the ball. And he didn't do that.
Base hit for Westerberg to lead off the bottom of the fifth inning. And we'll see Tyler Ammerman up to the plate now as he fouls the first pitch back.
And again, steady. You got a little bullpen party over there with the Nighthawks. I'm counting. I got three guys throwing right now for the Nighthawks. And our bullpen looks like a ghost town. There's nobody even in it right now. Marlowe is just cruising.
And the 0-1 pitch is going to miss for ball one to even the count up.
And with the Pacers having a few days off from games, we'll give our pitching staff a chance to recuperate for Payne College as they come in Wednesday at 6 p.m. here at the Burt.
That one fouled back, and the count is now 1-2. Even Marlowe continues with a good game. Might see another pitcher come in just to try to give him a little bit of work before the break.
Well, yeah, you don't want to burn Marlowe out. It's a one-game series with Payne. But if you want to call that a series.
1-2 pitch. That'll be a base hit into center field. And the leadoff men are aboard here on first and second, as we'll see the leadoff hitter in Skyler Mercado. Mercado is 1-for-3 today with a single and a run scored.
And we've seen Coach Thomas play around with the leadoff hitters. We've seen anybody from Chaz Powell to Ammerman to Mercado leading off. Mitchell Price. Ammerman, I might be wrong on that one. But Mitchell Price, those are three that I've definitely seen him tinker around with the lineup on.
Well, Mercado's been doing a pretty decent job as the leadoff man as he takes strike one.
Yep.
Price is definitely a good one as a leadoff batter. You get him aboard, and you're going to have some speed coming up. And, you got Brian Pereira sitting at number 3 and Zach Moon at number 4. If either of those guys come up, it's going to be trouble.
That's a scary little piece of the lineup to deal with. And Mercado catches that one off his heels.
And there's the double play there. But there's going to be Westerberg over on third on that double play ball, and we're going to see Chaz Powell come up. Chaz Powell 2-for-2 today. Two doubles, one of which was an RBI double, has been hit by a pitch and has come around to score 3 times. Now he has a runner on third base with 2 outs. He's trying to sell that one there as he kind of jutted himself out there. But umpire was going to call it a strike anyway. That one in the dirt. Evens the count at 1-1. That one's going to be a base hit into right field.
And that will continue our scoring streak here at the bottom of the fifth.
Thought Delgado might be able to come up with a catch there, but it was just a little bit over his glove as he jumped for it. So an RBI base hit for Chaz Powell makes him 3-for-3 on the day, and that'll bring up Brian Pereira. Pereira is 2-for-3 today, an RBI double back in the second. Base hit and 2 runs scored. First pitch to Pereira is in there for strike one. Oh, 1 pitch. That'll be popped up, staying in the infield. And Delgado calls for it and makes the catch for the final out. Pacers get 1, though, and add to their lead, making it 9-0 as we go into the top of the 6th by that score. Welcome to the top of the 6th inning, folks. Pacers lead at 9-0 here as the Nighthawks take their swings, and Gearhart's going to hit a hopper into left field for a base hit.
That was one of those hops. We saw this happen yesterday to their first baseman. His first step was forward, attack the ball. Don't wait for the ball to attack you. He stepped forward, and that meant the ball was able to hop over his head. And
this one cleared both Banks and Ammerman.
Ammerman trying to back him up was not able to get to it. And so nice piece of hitting there for Gearhart as
Connor Hoover steps up. 1-for-2 today with a double back in the fourth. First pitch to Hoover is going to be inside for ball one. And the 1-0 pitch. Just going to miss a bit outside, and the count 2-0. And now we're seeing a little bit of action in the Pacer bullpen as it finally has a population.
Yeah, there's got a few citizens living up in there now. Which you would expect that now, because, again, you don't want to burn Marlowe's arm up.
That one fouled off for strike one.
He's still throwing as strong as he ever did, but want to utilize him down the road.
2-1 the count to Hoover. That one in the dirt. Count now 3-1. And the 3-1 pitch. Inside for ball four. Hoover will take first on the walk. And that'll bring up Sam Tida back. We're going to see Sean run out there and have a little chat with Marlo.
And you really want to, again, you can't reiterate what Coach Thomas and staff has done with this team. You lose guys like Tyler Moore, TJ Costin. I go down the list of Ty Barkell, Sean Moore. There's so many great players on this team last year that, graduated. Many of those names that I just said have gone on to the next level and are playing for a shot at the pros. And this team that he's assembled, there's one guy out there in the field that was playing last year regularly, and that's Chaz Powell. And, early last season, Powell was at third, and then he moved to second, and now he's over in left field showing what an athlete he is. All these other players in the field right now, with the exception of Marlo and Sean, are new.
And they're doing a good job. Playing like seasoned veterans, as that one's fouled off for a 0-2 count.
And I'd say at this point in time, there's no such thing as a true freshman anymore. Everybody's gotten a little road tested. But to be sitting, where they're at in the rankings and to have the win losses, the number of wins that they have is a testimony of coaching and knowing how to replace really great players that, sadly, they had to leave eventually. But glad to have these young men that are on the field now.
The 1-2 the count as that pitch misses low and outside. And the 1-2 pitch. That one's going to be fouled back. And Tideback will just stay in there. And the 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss. Got him chasing one a little bit outside for strike three and the first out. I'll bring up Trevor Sams, the first baseman, 0-2 today with a strikeout. Sams comes up with runners on first and second, and only one down here in the top of the second inning with the Pacers leading 9-0. And Marlo steps off for a second. Pitch missing outside, and a count 1-0. And the 1-0 pitch.
Good looking breaking ball there. A little slider action.
Very nice as it fell into the strike zone. To even the count at 1-1. I can always appreciate a good pitch when I'm not facing it. And the 1-1. Just a little bit outside there. And the count now 2-1.
Got that one to catch the inside corner of the plate to make the count 2-2. Marlowe really dealing with his first bit of adversity in this game. Here at the top of the sixth.
Swing and a miss. Strikeout number two for the inning and the second out. That'll bring up Stephen Tomlinson with two down and runners on first and second. That strikeout is Marlowe's sixth of the game. That one's going to be over to Banks at third. He'll throw to second, and that's going to go into right field on a bad throw there by Banks. So one run's going to score, and there'll be runners on the corners with two outs, and the pace of lead is now cut to 9-1.
That's a tough break. Banks taking what looked to be the easier route, but in truth, he had Mercado racing towards second, had to put the ball in the right spot. He didn't do it. And obviously he gets past Mercado. That might have been one of those ones where you just go ahead and pull up and throw to first. Even though it's not your closest option, it was probably your smarter option there.
That first pitch is going to find the strike zone for strike one on Ryan Tomita.
Marlowe's slider is really working out well for him as he's got that one to come back in over the inside corner of the plate. Scary place to throw a slider.
0-1. It's going to be hit in the air into right field. Westerberg is there and makes the catch for the final out. But the Nighthawks get one here, and they cut the pace of the lead by one. 9-1 is the score going into the bottom of the sixth. Welcome to the bottom of the sixth, folks. Pacers lead 9-1, and leading off is the DH, Zach Moon. Moon 0-for-2 today with a walk. You're going to watch the first pitch go by for ball one. That one's going to be popped up in a shallow left. Coming on and making the catch is Hoover for the first out.
That's going to bring up Max Schoen to the plate for the Pacers.
Rarity of the day for Schoen as he's been held hitless today.
But he's been on twice, 2 for 3. Flat out his last at bat.
And we just need to stop talking about it.
He's hitting the ball well when he swings as he fouls that one straight back. Out of play.
And the 0-1 pitch. Get the inside part of the plate there for strike two. And a swing and a miss for strike three, and showing down on strikes for technically the second time today, although he reached on that first strikeout.
And they'll bring Mitchell Price up to the plate.
Price 1 for 3 today with an RBI single his last time up. A pitch high to Price for ball one. Pitch.
Breaking ball coming back in, catching the inside edge of the plate, even the count 1-1.
One pitch. It's going to be a little base hit into left field for Price. That'll bring up John Banks. Had a little error out there at third base, top half of this inning, but not too much of a costly error, as it only let in one run.
And Price had to muscle that ball. He caught that one off the hands and just muscled it between third and short. It rings out a true single no matter how you cut it.
That pitch falls into strike zone for strike one. Banks 1 for 2 today with 2 runs scored, a double, and a walk. One to Banks, and catching the lower part of the strike zone there for a quick 0-2 count.
That ball a little bit low on the inside edge for ball one. 1-2 is your count. Runner on first, 2 outs here at the bottom of the 6th.
One, two pitch. It's going to be hit in the air to center field, and it's going to be a nice catch by Delgado. Delgado covering a bit of ground there. To end the bottom of the 6th inning, Pacers unable to score for the first time in this game.
Our scoring streak is over.
As we're going into the top of the 7th, 9-1 score. Welcome to the top of the seventh inning, folks. Pacers leading 9-1 as Josh Peterson will lead off the top half of the seventh for the Nighthawks. Yeah, first pitch is going to miss for ball one. Peterson 1-for-2 today. And Jimmy Lynch is the new pitcher on the mound for the Pacers.
That'll get Jenny Law excited. Give her something to cheer on. She's a big Jimmy Lynch fan.
Gee, I wonder why.
I'm a big Jimmy Lynch fan for different reasons. We share a love for Dave Matthews Band. Enjoy our conversation, share stories, swapping stories about them. That one misses inside. 1-1 is your count. I do think Jenny was tickled when tickled emotionally that he finally shaved that mustache.
Swinging a foul there for a strike. And the 2-2 pitch. Ooh, just missing outside. Mm-hmm. And a count now full.
Held that one for a little while, giving that umpire a really good chance to think through that. But it's a full count, 3-2.
At inside and a leadoff walk here in the seventh to Peterson. That'll bring up Connor Corbett, who came in to hit for Profit. Profit 0-for-1 today. Flew out his first at bat.
Not that that's who's batting.
Corbett. Corbett's batting. Did I say Profit again?
You did.
I did say Profit again, didn't I?
Quick throw to first. An F for an internship. A lot happening on that little throw.
I think I failed my internship about 20 times now.
As Britt Hager, SID, says, yep.
And a pop-up there by Corbett into center field.
Not to be confused with Profit.
That's caught
squeezed
by Price.
By Mitchell Price. Also not to be confused by Profit.
Yes, I realize that.
And I'll bring up Eric Delgado. Doesn't even play outfield. He's a second baseman.
I was waiting for something.
Delgado made a fantastic play to end the inning.
Basically was playing in an outfield there when he made that catch. Another snap throw over to first and in the dirt, but Pereira is going to keep it in front of him.
Yeah, that range that Delgado shown running down that ball all the way out to right center field was fantastic. And it really something that it would be on a highlight film, the way he laid out to catch that.
1-0 pitch in the dirt for ball two.
Lynch. Maybe trying to throw a little too hard right now.
And here's the 2-0. That one's going to be outside for ball three. Count quickly, 3-0. That one in the strike zone there for strike one. And 3-1 comes up and in for ball four, and Delgado will draw the walk, putting runners on first and second.
And right now, Lynch is making things look a little more interesting than we want to see them. Runners on first and second.
And Gearhart now comes up. 1-for-3 today with a single and the only run scored for the Nighthawks so far. Comes up with one down. Runners on first and second. And he'll show a bunt there and pull it back as the ball finds the strike zone for strike one. Yo, one pitch. Low and outside and count even at 1-1. And the 1-1 is going to be a pop-up. Staying in the infield, Mercado makes the catch for the second out.
That's almost a gift to Jimmy Lynch to swing at that one. Lynch is having a little hard time getting his throwing plane on target.
Well, I mean, he is from Florida, and it's a pretty cool day out there, so that might have something to do with it. So Connor Hoover steps up, 1-for-2 today with a double and a walk. Comes up with 2 on and 2 out, and watches the first pitch go by for a strike.
Lynch took a lot off that one, put a little bend on it.
Very nice pitch.
For strike one.
Started out, it looked like above the strike zone, and ended up coming into the bottom part of it. The 0-1 pitch, straight fastball there is going to miss, evens the count at 1-1.
His fastball is what he's struggling with.
Looks like the sun is trying to peek out today for the first time. Here's the 1-1. Catching the outside part of the plate there. Count out 1-2. And the 1-2 pitch. Bit low, and the count even again at 2-2.
Lynch will step back off the rubber, recollect himself.
2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs, 2 on here in the top of the 7th inning for Connor Hoover as he's going to take a step out of the box. And the 2-2 pitch, swing and a miss for strike 3. And Jimmy Lynch gets himself out of a little bit of a jam here as we go into the bottom of the 7th inning with the 7th inning stretch. Pacers leading 9-1.
Takeaway and Fats Cafe, this is a 30-second radio spot titled A Million Bucks Poppy Seed Rolls Dinner Deal.
Every time you come into Fats Cafe, you get a big basket of our famous warm poppy seed rolls. People ask us all the time, these taste like a million bucks. Why would you give them away for free? The simple answer is, it's a good question. What are we doing?
Don't worry, our poppy seed rolls will always be free. Compliment them with one of a dozen delicious dinner entrees for under $10, like our deep dish chicken pot pie. Fats Cafe, feed your soul.
For Breakaway and Fats Cafe.
And welcome to the bottom of the seventh inning, folks. Pacers leading 9-1, and Niall Goings coming in to pinch hit for Luke Westerberg.
And on the mound for the Nighthawks is Avery Greer, sophomore righty out of Kennesaw, Georgia. He's a junior.
That first pitch is going to miss way outside for ball one.
That looked like my first pitch a few years ago here. The Pacers hit the Burt. That's where the catcher looks up at the batter and says, look, don't dig in. I don't know where this is going to go. And then say, I'm serious.
He just looks at, your guess is as good as mine.
It's a little Bull Durham reference.
And another one's going to miss.
And they've got two lefties in the bullpen right now. And right now, Mr. Greer's having a hard time getting his throwing plane on track. He's missed both of them hard. Outside of the range of even the athletic and agile Sam Titterback.
That one's in there for a strike and the count 3-1.
And if you're Niall, you're sitting there, you're probably not going to even take an offer at this one. Again, unless it is the pitch you're looking for.
And the 3-1. That one's outside. And Goings will draw a leadoff walk to start the bottom of the seventh. And Tyler Ammerman coming to the plate now, 1-for-3, with a single his last time up. That one fine in the upper part of the strike zone. Strike one. That one in dirt and goes to the backstop, and Goings is going to head on over to second on that wild pitch. A 1-1 the count to Ammerman with Goings on second. Outside, and the count now 2-1. Greer comes into this game with a 10.38 ERA, a 0-0 win-loss in his 8 appearances. And that one's going to be low on outside. Count 3-1. That one high and inside. So back-to-back walks put runners on first and second for the top of the order, and Joey Smithers coming in for Skyler Mercado.
Joey Smithers, a local product out of South Aiken High School, but it looks like we're going to see a pitching change here. As Greer just could not find his mechanics. They were a little off, and we're going to see a pitching change. So with that, let me go ahead and thank our sponsors as they get ready to warm up. We want to thank Tyler Tyronado, former Pacer softball player. Her and her husband own Tyler Tyronado, and we're thankful for their sponsorship, along with Bronze Body Tanning Salon, Quality Inn and Suites, South Carolina Education and Lottery, and Denny Michaelis, meeting all our insurance needs here in Aiken, South Carolina. And, of course, not to be outdone, but Fats Cafe, home of our Coach's Corner. Thank you for your sponsorship and making all this possible. And we're going to give you a chance to go top off your drinks. We'll be right back right after this pitch and change. And welcome back. Pitching change is in order. Did you find anything on this pitcher?
I have not found anything, so I can only assume this is his very first outing. And Jack Fleming is the new pitcher. He faces off against Joey Smithers. First pitch is going to be in there for strike one.
Smithers, again, local product out of South Aiken High School. I don't think I've seen Smithers bat yet.
Here's the 0-1. That's going to be a high fly ball into deep center field.
Put a good little charge into that one. Niall Goins is going to give him a look, and Niall Goins is going to challenge the throw, and he's going to make it easy. Niall looking fleet of foot going from second to third. And that was Smithers' first appearance. The pitcher's first appearance. I apologize.
And Goins is actually going to be out. He left the bag just before the ball was caught. So that'll be two down.
Goins has not had the best of luck on the base paths from last year to this year. He turned what would have been an easy triple into a single by not tagging second. So second base continues to be his nemesis as Chaz Powell comes to the plate with a runner on first.
Pitch is going to be inside for ball one. Tried to check his swing there, but he couldn't. Went around. So the count going to be even at 1-1. Chaz Powell having a good day today. 3-for-3 with two doubles, a single, hit by a pitch, and three runs scored. And two RBIs.
Good looking pitch there on the outside edge for a 1-2 count. Still no throwing in the Pacer bullpen, so we're going to get a little bit more out of Jimmy Lynch, give him a chance to figure some things out. With a 9-1 lead, you've got a little bit of a buffer zone.
That's going to be hit into the gap into left center field and drop in for a base hit.
Smithers will hold up at second, and that'll bring up Brian Pereira up to the plate.
And Brian Pereira comes up. 2-for-3 today with two runs scored, two RBIs, a double, and a single. That one's going to be pop foul and out of play for strike one. Oh, one pitch. We hit into center field for a base hit. And they are going to wave Ammerman around to score a run. Bases now lead 10-1 on the RBI single by Brian Pereira. And Zach Moon comes to the plate 0-for-3 today with a walk. He comes up with runners on first and second and two outs.
Who just scored? It should have been Smith.
No, it was Ammerman.
Ammerman scored?
Yeah.
Yeah, Marcus is going to go to internship for saying the wrong name.
Here's the 0-1 pitch to Moon. It's going to be high for ball one to even the count up. There's a 1-1 pitch to Moon. He's going to swing and miss at that one, and the count now 1-2. One-two pitch, swing and a miss by Moon for the final out of the bottom of the seventh inning. Pacers get one as they lead 10-1 going into the eighth. Welcome to the top of the eighth. Pacers leading 10-1. And the Nighthawks will lead off with Sam Tiedebeck, who's 0-3 today. And Jimmy Lynch deals a first pitch strike.
He's starting off with that little slider of his, which he's had great control over. It's his fastball that he was struggling with earlier. And that fastball sent out of play for strike two.
And the 0-2 pitch. Swinging a foul tip right into the glove of Schoen. Schoen had to show the umpire that he caught it.
And much relief to Jimmy's parents, who I'm sure are watching down in Florida. He seems like he's kind of gathered himself, got his throwing plane back on track. He's throwing the ball well now.
That'll bring up Trevor Sams, also 0-3 today with a pair of strikeouts. And that first pitch is going to miss inside for ball one. One-oh pitch. He popped up into right field.
Now Goins on his horse, and he's
unable
to get to it.
They've dropped into foul territory, though, so it'll just be a strike.
And this will give me a chance to give a shout-out to the Pacers softball players who were here earlier, but they had a race over for a softball practice. They've got a big game coming up this week. But Sarah Montai, Brielle Jungblut, Megan Jean Thrower. Always glad to have you guys around. Samantha Chubb, ballers one and all.
And 1-1 the count to Sams as he swings at that one and fouls it off to make the count 1-2. And the 1-2 pitch, that'll be popped up into shallow right field, and that's going to drop in for a base hit. I'll bring up Stephen Tomlinson, 0-3 and reached on an error. Comes up with one down and a runner on first, as the Nighthawks trail the Pacers 10-1 here in the top of the eighth inning. Swing and a foul on that one. Four, strike one.
And the sun seems to have just popped up right over our field as I'm looking at nothing but clouds all around.
I see a few clouds starting to creep into the outfield, so.
The wind is still fairly dormant for the Burt. You look at a pitch there by Lynch as he adds a strike to the count. Now 0-2.
Oh, 2 to Tomlinson. He'll foul that one off, wasting a pitch, keeping the count at 0-2. That one's going to be hit into right field, and Goings is going to chase after it, and he's going to make a nice little catch for the second out. So he was unable to track one of them down, but he tracked this one down and reached up and got it. And that'll put two down and one on for Ryan Tomita. Tomita 1-for-3 today with a single. That one pretty much right down the middle there for strike one.
Yeah, Lynch has definitely worked some things out from his previous inning. He seems to be in control here with his fastball. That was what was giving him a hard time, as that one's high and inside for ball one. His fastball was giving him a little bit of a problem, but he seems to have worked that out.
And the 1-1 pitch. Grounded up the middle there. Ahriman's going to have to get to it. Flip to second for the out.
No need for a double play as there was already two outs.
Indeed, and that'll do it for the top of the eighth. We're going into the bottom. 10-1, still the score. Well, into the bottom of the eighth inning, Max Schoen leads it off, and in a rare spot is looking for his first hit. He faces off against Bryce Harrison, the new pitcher. And he's going to hit a high fly ball there into left field. And that's going to be caught by Corbett for the first out. Yeah, Corbett, not Profit.
Agreed. And that's going to bring Mitchell Price up to the plate.
Price is 2-for-2 today with an RBI single and just a plain old single. Comes up with nobody on and one out here in a 10-1 ball game. First pitch is in the dirt.
And Harrison seemed to reach way back to try to add a little extra spice on that pitch.
That pitch missing high and a little outside for a 2-0 count.
Harrison's got a little zip on his fastball, though.
Two-o pitch. That one just missing as well, and the count quickly 3-0. And that one's going to be high, and Price draws a 4-pitch walk with one down. I'll bring up John Banks, who is going to be sitting out as Dave Langster comes in.
One of the perks of a 10-1 lead, get to kind of get some guys some playing time here late in the game. A little game experience. Good looking pitch there for strike one.
And the 0-1 pitch.
Check swing. He's called strike for 0-2 count.
He managed to hold up, but it didn't matter.
Yeah, Harrison's definitely, like I said, he's bringing some pretty good heat here. I don't see a lot of movement on it, but it gets there quick. That ball, he lets go a little early, and it sails on him for ball one. Count is 1-2.
Here's a 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss. And down on strikes is Langster for the second out.
Now bring Niall Goins up to the plate.
Niall Goins walked and was thrown out trying to advance to third. Did not tag second in time, or he left second too early, I should say. First pitch to Goins is in the dirt. Ball one.
And Niall Goins is a great kid, and last year he had that situation where he hit a triple and forgot to touch second. And he took his ribbing like a man.
A 1-0 pitch. Lower part of the strike zone for strike one to even the count.
And Goins is one of those batters, if he can make contact with it, he can put a charge into a baseball pretty quick.
Also noticing there's a new catcher behind the plate for the Nighthawks. We have Kevin Krupp, as that one's going to be a slow bouncer to first. And stepping out of the bag is Sams for the third and final out of the inning. The Pacers are unable to score once again as we go into the top of the ninth, looking to close out this game. 10-1 the score. And we are in the top of the ninth inning. Pacers leading 10-1. They turn to Nick Jost to close it out. As the Nighthawks look to Josh Peterson to try to keep him alive and make a heck of a comeback here.
And Douglas Hard will replace Sean at behind the plate for the Pacers. Josh Peterson taking the first pitch called ball. Good job by Jimmy Lynch. Come in and give us a couple of solid pitches.
And the 1-0. Outside part of the plate. 4 strike 1 to even the count up. Peterson 1 for 2 today with a strikeout and a single. He's also walked. Here's the 1-1 pitch. That's a high fly ball into right field, and that one is going to just go over the fence and gone. The solo home run for Peterson to lead off the ninth. Cuts the Pacer lead 10-2.
A good piece of hitting by Josh Peterson. Might prove to be a little too late, but you got to feel good coming into the game and being able to send a dinger back over the wall. Of course, against a guy like Yost, who's as hard as Yost throws the ball, any contact's got a chance.
Oh, yeah, and right there it did.
Now bring up Connor Corbett up to the plate.
Corbett 0 for 2 today. That pitch is going to be high and inside for ball one.
Anything inside is going to make your heart race a little bit with Jost on the mound.
Here's the 1-0. That's in there for strike one to even the count at 1-1.
Breaking ball over the plate, hard of the plate too, 1-2. Nobody was looking for that pitch, especially the batter.
That's one of the things that Jost is able to do. He can throw one of those off speeders in there every now and again. And here's the 1-2. That one's inside.
And that's going to catch the home plate umpire a little bit as it came inside. And whew. You have to take a little walk right there. You're going to walk that one off and give Jost a little, hey, let's not do that again. Jost with a little chuckle there.
Surprised he doesn't slap Art on the back of the head there. Like, why didn't you catch that?
But handled well by the home plate umpire. He recovers and kept his feet the whole time. I'll give him that. I would have taken a shot like that, like a gunshot wound. I would have hit the ground and squealed.
Calling for a medic.
But we're back in business with a 2-2 count. Corbett will dig back in. Probably not digging too deep.
2-2 pitch, swing and a miss for strike three and the first out of the inning.
That's going to bring Taylor Jones to the plate.
Taylor Jones in for Delgado.
Senior out of Macon, Georgia. He'll be hitting from the left side of the plate.
First pitch is in there for strike one, lower part of the strike zone there, but a strike nonetheless. Here's the 0-1 pitch.
Breaking ball catching the outside edge of the plate for strike two. Good looking pitch.
So 0-2, the count to Jones. Jones batting 176 on the year. One home run and six RBIs. As he fouls that one off. Keeping the count at 0-2. That one's going to go over Joe's head. On the throwback from Ard.
Can you have an error in that situation?
I mean, sure as heck feels like it.
Doug Ard. Glad to have him. Great kid on the program, part of the program. Solid student athlete.
0-2 on the outside part of the plate for strike three, and Jones down looking. I'll put two down in the inning, and we're going to see Devin Gearhart, the leadoff man, coming up as the final hope for North Georgia. First pitch to Gearhart, in there for strike one. Here's the 0-1 pitch. That's a high fly ball into left right field. It goes into the near the dugout. I did it again.
Almost to the bullpen. For the Nighthawks. You corrected yourself. You caught it.
I caught it. I did catch
it. That's a start in the right direction.
Seems like I almost do that just about once every game. The 0-2 is the count to Gearhart.
Might want to work on that.
I do need to work on it. I've been doing that at home whenever watching the spring training games.
I will say you hit center field every time.
Shocking. That pitch low. Actually, no, there was one time I missed center field, believe it or not. I called it left-right field. There's a 1-2 from Jobst. That one just going to miss. Count even at 2-2. And that one's going to be inside, and Ard trying to frame it. But the count is now going to be full at 3-2. So a good at-bat here by Gearhart to work the count full. That one's inside, and Gearhart will draw a two-out walk here in the ninth.
That's going to bring up Kevin Krupp.
Oh, Connor Hoover coming
Connor
up.
Connor Hoover, I'm sorry. I saw Krupp picking up a bat.
Yeah, Krupp is going to be on deck. On the chance that Hoover makes it on base, he will be up. Hoover 1-for-3 today with a double and a walk and a strikeout. First pitch is in there for strike one. Swinging a foul tip into the glove of Ard. And the count quickly 0-2. And once again, North Georgia down to their last strike. And that one's in there for a call strike three. And that'll do it as the Pacers win this game 10-2 and take the series sweep over North Georgia. Pacers win it on 13 hits with one error, and the Hawks had 6 hits on 3 errors. We thank you for joining us, and we will be back in action against Payne on Wednesday at 6 o'clock. Afterwards, we'll start up a three-game series against Montevallo on March 25th, and then a doubleheader against Montevallo on the 26th, starting at 1 p.m. I'm Marcus Johnson, and have a good one.